You have signed up for it. You have signed up for multiple sleepless nights in a row.
Today, we are going to cover a very interesting topic on what is taught inside a fashion design school. Now, this topic is based on hundreds of requests that I'm getting from my YouTube channel followers and also from all the schools that I visit for lecturing on fashion design. All the students who are interested in preparing for fashion design colleges, they always ask that what is it that they would cover when they actually get inside a design college. So you, for preparation of design colleges, students have two ways. One, they prepare on their own or they join a coaching center. And inside the coaching center, they are taught primarily all the subjects which are going to help them in cracking the entrance exam. But what is taught inside the fashion design college, that is still a mystery for most of them. So for today's conversation, we are going to be joined by a special guest who is a brilliant fashion design student and pursuing her fashion design course from NIFT New Delhi. And she is going to let us know what all she has covered in her first year so that it demystifies all the secrets that a design college holds.
So when I did get in and I had a All India rank 77, that was a very proud moment for me, but also very surreal. The first week where I was at NIFT, it was absolutely unbelievable. I remember going to the washroom and just fixing my hair, and it was very hard for me to believe that I had finally gotten into the dream college that I wanted to be in. We have an orientation during the first week of our college, and a lot of our seniors, a lot of alumni from came in and told us it's a great achievement to have been able to do. It's a great start to that long journey that I have. So that's how I felt after, you know, clearing NIFT and being in NIFT for the first few weeks. I was a commerce student and I had commerce with maths. My mother is a maths teacher and she's very supportive of what I'm doing, but she just wouldn't agree for me to leave maths. And I was fairly good at maths, so it was not really an issue for me. I struggled while I was in 11th and 12th, but again, I managed. And I took commerce and maths, and I just want everyone else who's, you know, applying for this course to know that the stream that we take in 11th or 12th does not define our designing career or even the entrance exam. It has nothing to do with the entrance exam that we give. It does not influence it. Obviously, if you have fine arts as a subject in your 11th and 12th, it will help you. But I did not have fine arts and I did just fine. It is not a defining moment. So in my experience, and I think I speak for everybody at NIFT when I say this, school life and NIFT life is absolutely different. For that matter, NIFT experience is very different from DU experience or any other college for that matter. To start off, I'll compare my school experience with my NIFT experience. School in general is a very protected place. Studying with people who are usually locally from that particular state that you're in. So it's very protective, one. Two, you're not exposed to a lot of people. You're just around a certain group of people. And those people are usually very, they have varied interests and they're very varied people, but definitely not as varied as college. So NIFT, talking about NIFT and college, first of all, you meet people from around the nation, which in itself is such a great exposure to hear different people's stories about where they come from and how they got into NIFT, especially because NIFT is a design school, and not every parent is open to the idea of sending their kids off to a design school, especially boys. So just hearing those stories and comparing notes on how my parents were very supportive, but there are parents out there who are not as supportive. Other than that, academic-wise, school, yeah, we used to have projects. We used to have homework, holiday homework, which was supposed to be very creative and very fancy. Now, NIFT is a much bigger version and a much important version of that holiday homework. I used to wait for holiday homework in school because I could decorate it. And that was my highlight from school. NIFT is about doing that only, but on a much serious and on a much bigger scale. So it's a dream for a person like me to be in NIFT because I get to do what I love. I'm not sitting with books 24/7, or I'm not sitting with books that I'm trying to mug up this concept. No, I'm doing my research, and I'm doing a lot of research. I'm reading a lot of books, but I'm reading the books that I want to read. I'm reading about the topics that I want to read. NIFT Delhi happens to have the Asia's best fashion library, and to just pick up any random book from the library and start to read it, it's amazing. I cannot explain in words how good that feels. In school, we do spend a lot of time studying, but not as much as NIFT. NIFT actually, I just want to put it out there, NIFT actually requires you to be so dedicated. You will have to sleepless nights without, you know, you don't even get to crib about it, because that's just how it is. And you need to know that if you're applying for NIFT, you have signed up for it. You have signed up for multiple sleepless nights in a row. And while it is very hard and very difficult, it's also very fulfilling to be able to finish a project in 2 or 3 sleepless nights, if you know, if that's how it is. NIFT Bachelor's in Design is a 4-year course, and it usually starts with the foundation year. Foundation year is the first year, and as the name suggests, it's the very foundation of everything that you will learn during your 4 years at NIFT. So during this year, you're not in your department that you've previously chosen during counseling. You're just mixed up with all the departments into a batch. And in that batch, you study about 10 subjects approximately over the year, over the entire year, wherein all of these subjects are not specific to a department, they're general. For example, we have a subject called material studies. As the name suggests, we're studying the different types of materials. So for me, when I was in foundation year, the three subjects, the three materials that we studied were yarn, metal, and recycling material, that is waste. So we explored with yarns in this art form called macrame. So I actually found a passion in macrame, and I conducted a lot of workshops very recently for macrame for a lot of students during lockdown, which was an online workshop, very fun. Other than that, we had metal, which to me was absolutely new, as was to most of the students there, because working with heavy machinery, it's very overwhelming, but it's also a lot of fun. So we worked with machinery in the lab, and then we had recycling material where we were just using waste to create best out of waste situations. So in the recycling material project, we were given a theme. So our theme was Christmas or New Year's. We had to choose between the two, and I had chosen Christmas. And then we created an entire mood board of Christmas, of the materials or the colors that we could think of that we associate with Christmas. And then taking inspiration from this entire mood board, we created our final product. So I had a cycle lying around that my brother didn't need. So I took off the tire of the cycle without telling him, which was a fight in itself. But I took off the tire and I found waste paper lying and made origami flowers out of it. And then I had a few scrap plastic flowers that we have. So I used the stem of that. and then attached my paper flask to that stem that was previously waste. And then I attached that around the tires and made a Christmas wheel sort of a situation where you could write your wishes and pin it on that. So that was my recycling project, and I actually happened to score full marks in that subject. So next we had digital design and communication. This subject is very technical and it's mostly digital. So you learn different Adobe softwares. So we learned Illustrator, Photoshop, InDesign. One of the other subjects that we had were fashion basics, which was my personal favorite subject. In this subject, we learn a lot about fashion terminologies and different fashion categories and cultures and subcultures. So by learning about the cultures, we learned about punk fashion, gothic fashion, heavy metal, all of these things. And our very first assignment was to walk the ramp dressed as different subculture. So we were divided into groups. Each group had a subculture and we had to do a fashion walk. And I mean, how amazing is it to get scored for dressing up and to have that as a first assignment? I mean, imagine. We have another very important subject called Self and Society. Self and Society is slightly economics based. We learned about macro and micro units. So for us at NIFTELI, it included serving one of the very nearest markets, which is called Shahpur Jat. Shahpur Jat is a fashion hub in a way in Delhi, where you can find a lot of good designer stores. And what we were supposed to do was choose one of those stores and do an entire detailed study of how the entire store works. So for my group, it was a very small unit, which was sort of like a factory unit. And during the entire semester, we decoded their entire method of taking fabric and converting that into an outfit that they can sell. And they did not sell it. They were an outsourced company. And they used to send it to different companies to sell. So that is, again, a very enlightening subject, because you get to study and get to know the workings of the industry, which is just as important as actually being a designer. Because ultimately, we need to sell and we need to know how to produce to be able to sell. The final subject for the first semester, not the final subject, for drawing, most of our assignments were as we wished, but for example, perspective was one of our topics during the drawing assignment, and we were supposed to go sit wherever we like in the campus and draw whatever building that is nearest to us in perspective. There's not a lot of pressure at NIF in terms of when you're working. Obviously, there's pressure of submitting the work on time and with the standard that is expected out of us. But while you're working, we were never pressurized to do it a certain way or be prim and proper about it. That was never an issue for us. The second semester, we have a subject called Creative Thinking Skills. Creative Thinking Skills, the subject is about the process and not about the final design as much. So we were given assignments, and we were supposed to create designs. But those designs had to come through a proper process. For example, there's a technique called scamper. So we were taught that technique, and then we were supposed to come up with a design using that technique. So this subject is mostly about using techniques to derive your design. Then we had a subject called Design Fundamentals. Design Fundamentals, again, is one of my favorite subjects, which is about elements of design and principles of design. And the final jury was about taking one of your past experiences and then using elements and elements and principles of design to be able to create an art piece that reflected that entire experience. And the final subject for the entire first year is art and design aesthetics. So this subject is very theoretical. It teaches you about the different artistic abilities of different civilizations. And it also teaches you a lot about the different art movements and a lot about the different artists. And it's obviously an interpretation of different paintings. We're all allowed to voice our opinions and voice our interpretations in the course of this subject. And we have very, very enlightening conversations when we are studying the subject. I had a very fun time discussing different paintings with Sir. So I was very privileged to have a great teacher, and you will be too when you're at NIPT. Every teacher is amazing.